My name is Advait Vilas Kakde. I am from Nayar Hospital. I am a medical student. My question is, we are actually very fortunate to get this human form of life. This is very, very rare, which comes from millions and millions years. So in what respect we should utilize that human form of life? Or what is the most sublime aim in our life? Or what is the real goal of human form of life?
The brother said that he is a medical student from Nayar Hospital. I have to mention that even I passed from Nayar Hospital, same hospital. I passed from the same medical college, Nayar Hospital. I passed in 1991, approximately 16 years back. The brother asked the question that we get this human life. How should we utilize this human life? Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Dariyat, chapter number 51, verse number 56, that we have created the men and the jinn not but to worship him. Worship him means obeying him. So the best we can do with this human life is to obey the commandments of Almighty God and let peace prevail in this world and the hereafter. The creator of the human beings, he will be the best person to give the answer. It's mentioned in Surah Mulk, chapter number 67, verse number 2. Alladhi khalaqal mauta wal hayata. It's Allah who has created death and life to test which of you is good indeed. This life that we have, brother, is a test for the hereafter. We are undergoing a test. And if we follow the commandments of our Creator and lead life according to what He has said and let peace prevail by submitting our will to the Creator, we'll be successful in this world as well as the hereafter. Hope that answers the question.
Yes, but what we shouldn't, we young student, what should you do for that?
What you should do? Brother should read the Quran. Read the Quran and implement on the guidance of the Quran. If you read the Veda speaks about one God, no idol worship. The Veda says there is a Rishi to come, there is a Kalki Avatar to come. He will show you good things. That Kalki Avatar is Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This Quran is the last and final revelation of Almighty God to the last and final messenger Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Read this message, accept it, so that there is peace in this world as well as in Akhirah. Hope that answers the question, brother.
Thank you very much.
Yes, sister. We request the audience to kindly remain seated. We have some more time to go.
Myself, Aarti. I am a non-Muslim. I'd like to ask a question that, first of all, very thanks for your and giving me this opportunity to listen to you and understand Islam. What I understood from your talk is mainly that it's a religion which believes in peace, peace and harmony and scientific and rational beliefs. If it is so, then how does it believe in the whole idea of God, and how does it believe the whole idea of heaven or the hell? If it's so rational.
Sister has a question that she has heard the lecture. She's very happy to know Islam is a religion of peace and it's a scientific religion, it's a rational religion. She's asking that if Islam is a rational religion, then how come it believes in God, it believes in heaven and hell? Sister, the only way you can believe in God is through science. Today, if I have to prove to an atheist, the only way I can prove is through the Quran, with the help of science. The best tool I've got today, previously it was miracles, then came the age of literature and poetry. Every age, Quran is a miracle of miracle. It's a miracle of all times. So because of this, if you heard my talk, I've proved that because a person who believes in science, if he's rational, he will have to agree that Quran is the word of God. If he does not believe in science, if he's not rational, if he's not understanding, there's high chances he will not believe in the Quran. That is the reason I said today, science is not eliminating God, it is eliminating models of God. And furthermore, there are many things, for example, heaven and hell. As far as science is concerned, the concept of God, most of the scientists, they believe in the existence of God today. Previously, according to Francis Bacon, it says that little knowledge of science makes you an atheist, but in-depth knowledge of science makes you a believer in God. Now coming to your second question about heaven and hell. Now, if you analyze the Quran, whatever the Quran speaks about science, approximately you can say that 80% what the Quran speaks about science has been proved to be 100% correct. About the creation of the universe, about the shape of the earth, light of the moon, that the sun rotates and revolves, water cycle, geology, botany, etc. 80% of what the Quran speaks about science is 100% proved to be correct. The remaining 20%, it goes in the ambiguous slot, neither right, neither wrong. So my logic says, when 80% is 100% correct, and the remaining 20% is neither right, neither wrong, not even 0.1% of the 20% have been proved to be wrong, my logic says that inshallah, God willing, even the 20% will be right. So heaven and hell, angels, jinn, science hasn't advanced that far. Today science has advanced maybe to understand 80% of the Quranic verses we speak about science. Tomorrow, maybe 50 years later, 100 years later, 200 years later, science will talk about heaven, will talk about hell, will talk about jinn. But so my logic says, it's not an illogical belief. It's a logical belief. When 80% is 100% correct, and the remaining 20%, not even 0.1% is wrong, no scientist today can say that he can prove scientifically there is no hell. No scientist today can prove scientifically there is no heaven. He can say, I don't know. Maybe it is, maybe it is not. It is ambiguous. So my logic says when 20% is ambiguous, neither right, neither wrong, when 80% 100% correct, I being a scientific person, I being a rational person, I say that inshallah, God willing, even that 20% will be correct. That is the reason I believe in hell, I believe in heaven, and also believe in the angels and the jinn. Hope that answers the question.
I still have some clarification. I need some clarification.
Anything connected with the same question?
Yes, sir.
Quickly, sister.
You said that science also follows or believes in God, or also Islam do that. Then what is the exact explanation that is that it has given for God or for heaven or hell?
Sister, did you hear my full talk?
Yeah.
Did you hear my talk which I gave earlier last week? Is the Quran God's word?
No, sir.
Fine.
This is my first talk.
So in this talk, I spent 15 minutes trying to do and to repeat in a nutshell what I spoke in 2 hours. What I request you take my video cassette recording, is the Quran God's word? And I've proved there that Quran is God's word, and also proved to an atheist the existence of Almighty God, which I did today in a nutshell, but in a fast way. So I've proved that God has to exist. If God did not exist, who wrote this Quran? Who wrote this Quran 1400 years ago? Talking about...
My question is also, then who wrote this Quran?
Who wrote it? The Creator wrote it. God wrote it.
What
no human being can write. Sorry?
What is the explanation for that?
The explanation is my talk of 2 hours, sister. You can take the video cassette. And the similar talk I'd given in Bombay in 1995. I'll request some of the volunteers, the lady volunteer, to give you a copy of my talk, which I said in 1995 in Billa Matoshri. Take that talk. Inshallah, it will give you more details about the explanation of God, as well as the existence of God, and Quran is the word of God. Hope that answers the question.
Sister, you can collect the book also, Quran and Modern Science, on the way out, as well as Is the Quran God Word? These should satisfy most of your answers on that topic. Yes, brother.
Thank you, sir. Sir, I am Dr. Rajesh. I am a homeopathic doctor. And I have two questions that I have read that about Muhammad Peygamber as the last and the final prophet. Why the stress is given on the word last and the final? And are you afraid of any new one? And if God decides and will send a new one, don't you welcome him? And agar main upar wale ka didar karna chahta hoon, to Islam is la kya solution hai? Thank you, sir.
Brother, last two questions. One thing, that why do you stress so much that he's the last prophet? If God wants to send a second one, can't he send? And you would like to say the last part, kya bole apne? Aap didar karna chahte?
Agar main yaar koi bhi vyakti agar Allah ke didar karna chahta hai, to uske liye Islam mein kya solution hai?
And the last question, if I want to see Almighty God, what is the solution? I'll come to the last question later.
Yes, sir,
the first question, why do I